Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics 1. This lecture is entitled Exclusive OR and Exclusive NOR Logic Gate Functions. Notice up front, I did not say XOR or XNOR. That is one way to ruin an otherwise stunning interview. Go ahead and tell them about your digital electronics experience and say that you know XOR and XNOR gates. No one says them that way. So they're exclusive ORs and exclusive NORs. And I'm actually going to go ahead and knock out both of these gates in this particular lecture and kind of round up all of our second string of logic gates. They're not exactly that different. It's just kind of an inversion of each other. And again, how are they made? They are made of combinations of ANDs, NOTs, and ORs. However, they are so basic and used so often, they have their own logic symbol and they are used pretty commonly in a lot of these circuits. So we develop a truth table for them and a symbol and such and such. The symbol, exclusive OR, looks kind of like that little spaceship looking thing on the left. It's like an OR with an extra scoop on the left. Exclusive NOR, same thing, except it's got a bubble on it. The rectangular symbol for these things, exclusive OR, it's a box. Input's coming in on the left, output coming out on the right. Whereas an OR had a greater than and equal to 1, this one's got an equal to 1. Exclusive NOR, it's got that equal to 1, and because it's a negation, it's got that little flag. Other than that, forget about those, just in case you ever see it. What does the truth table for these look like, and how do they function? The best way to describe, for my purposes, how I like to think of the exclusive OR, and I'm kind of limiting this to two inputs now. A and B. There really is such a thing as a three-input, multiple-input ones, but I'm just going to kind of limit it to two right now. It's high if it's different. Output is high if the inputs are different. And that's really kind of a description only for the two-input exclusive OR, and that's kind of what we use a lot. We'll add to this description a little bit later. The output high if the inputs are different. So look at this first one. We've got 0, 0. They're not different. They're the same. 0. B is a 0, A is a 1. They're different, the output's high. B is a 1, A is a 0, they're different, 1. Finally, B is a 1, A is a 1, they're the same. There you go. What's the exclusive NOR? Don't even remember anything, just remember it's the opposite of this one. So if you want to do that, all you do is just say 1, 0, 0, 1. There you go. If I was to come up with a description for that, maybe I would say the output is high if inputs are the same. And again, that's kind of limiting it just to two inputs right now. These are pretty handy definitions to me because it kind of hints at the function of an exclusive OR and an exclusive NOR. I mean, just think about the exclusive NOR. It's an equality detector. Remember one of those common logic functions we discussed is a comparator. Think about it, it's comparing two numbers, number A and number B. Are they equal? Yeah, 0 is equal to 0. Yeah, 1 is equal to 1. That's a pretty neat application right there of an exclusive NOR. It's an equality detector. Another thing an exclusive NOR could be used for is just kind of a fact checker. You know, have some logic circuit with all these inputs perform some crazy calculation and have it spit out an output. But at the same time, have those same inputs being fed into some other crazy computer with some crazy logic output. And ideally, if they're running correctly, they should have the same output. And all you do is you have this exclusive NOR checking, hey, do these guys agree? Yes, they agree. No, they don't. There's a problem. One of these guys is wrong. It's a neat basic application for an exclusive NOR. It's an equality detector. It's an error checker. One of the applications for an exclusive OR could be it's an equality detector. Ideally, they should be having the same results, and if they're the same results, you should have a 0, and if you get different results, it's a 1. It's the kind of the same thing I just drew, except you can either source or sync, depending on using exclusive OR or exclusive NOR. Quality detection, difference detection. What are the symbols for these things? All right, they're used so commonly. They actually do have some funny symbols. I can say A exclusive OR B. And it's a plus with a circle around it. X is equal to A exclusive OR B. For an exclusive NOR, it's A is circle dot B. It's just its little funny symbol. That's the exclusive OR symbol. You may not see that ever again. Talk how these things are working out. You will see the SOP implementation of these things. You should be able to recognize that, though. How does VHDL write these? X is assigned A, X or B. Exclusive OR B. Exclusive NOR. X is assigned A, exclusive NOR B. Actually, let's just go into some timing diagrams. Okay, so we talked about the truth table, talked about how to write the expressions, talked about the description of them. Let's just do some timing diagrams. Here I've got signal A and signal B. Here I've got an exclusive OR and an exclusive NOR. So go ahead and pause the recording and see if you can come up with what the exclusive OR output will look like. We'll talk about that one in specifically, then we'll move on to the next one, because I'm going to go ahead and pause it and do my estimation of it. Okay, there you go. That is my estimate of how an exclusive OR would behave. And again, what's it trying to do? It's highlighting, hey, there's a difference between A and B. There's a difference between A and B. Difference between A and B. Whereas all those other times, for example, right here, both A and B are zero. So like the machines are agreeing with each other. They're both zero and they're both one. So go ahead and see what you can do with an exclusive NOR. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and pause the recording and go ahead and put down what my output would look like for an exclusive NOR. Okay, and there is what I've got for an exclusive NOR. Yeah, you could kind of shortcut it and just say, I'm going to invert what the exclusive OR has got on it. But let's say you didn't have that exclusive OR. What I'm doing is saying, okay, it's the same. A and B are the same. So it's going to go high. A and B are the same. It's going to go high. The same goes high. Same. It goes high. Pretty quick and easy about those gates. The exclusive OR in particular has got some pretty cool applications to it. One of those applications is what's called selective inversion. Selective inversion is a property with an exclusive OR gate that, let's say I've got an incoming data stream on one of the inputs for the exclusive OR, and the other input can switch from plus 5 volts to ground, i.e. logical high or logical zero. What's the output here in one of those two positions? Okay, so let's say for this first one, B is constantly a 1, and in the second one, B is constantly a 0. How does the output look in both of those situations? Okay, when B is a 1 and B is a 0. Go ahead, put your estimate in there, and we'll see what it looks like, because I'm going to go ahead and pause the recording and put in what it should look like. And this is my best estimate of what I'm seeing right here. Just look at the outputs for that exclusive OR and see if they look similar to you. When B is a 0, i.e. this one on the bottom here, doesn't our output look a lot like our input? So when B equals 0, A exclusive OR was 0, I'm going to get A. What does the output look like when B is a 1? Doesn't this look like the opposite, the inversion of it? Hence the term selective inversion. I can use one input on an exclusive OR to tell it, hey, invert it, don't invert it. And so what I've got here is A OR exclusive OR 1. It's the inversion of A. Why is this super handy? Well, think about a sourcing or syncing arrangement. Sometimes you want a 0 to light it up. Sometimes you want a 1 to light it up. Sometimes you want to go active high. Sometimes you want to go active low. Watch, make sure your head doesn't explode. Oftentimes, you'll see sometimes at the end of a very complicated logic circuit, this thing at the very end, you've got this incredibly complicated logic circuit that's being fed to an exclusive OR that ultimately you can put it to a 1 or switch that switch over to a 0. When it's at a 1, let's say our output was A, we've got an inverted A. When it's switched to a 0, we're not inverting it. That's a pretty cool application called selective inversion. Another common application of the exclusive OR is adding. Okay, so I'm tricking you guys into your first function. I've actually already tricked you into a couple of these things. We've already talked about comparators. We've already talked about some logical functions already. So one of the more complicated logical functions we're going to talk about is the adding. Think about here, 0 plus 0, we're going to get a 0 sum and a 0 carry. 0 plus a 1 is a 1 sum with a 0 carry. 1 plus a 0 is a 1 with a 0 carry. 1 plus a 1 is a 0 with a 1 carry. Look at just the sum bits for now and think of a truth table lying on its side. 0, 1, 1, 0. Doesn't that look like the truth table? 0, 1, 1, 0 for the exclusive OR? And that's exactly what the sum bit is for a half adder. We'll discuss the difference between half adders and full adders in a little bit here. So if I'm going to try to add the number A and B, my sum bit is the exclusive OR of A and B. And while we're at it, what's our carry bit? 0, 0, 0, 1. Doesn't that look like the truth table for an AND gate? What I can do is take my AND gate, and there's my carry, or carry out particularly, because we'll talk about it. Carry ins. There is such a thing as a carry in. So what I've just drawn right here is what's known as a half adder. I'm producing the carry out, i.e. the MSB, and the sum, the LSB, of 2-bit addition. Pretty cool, huh? I want to discuss actually how an exclusive OR is made, and an exclusive NOR for that matter. And what I'm going to do is use the truth table to kind of give you guys a brief intro to the SOP, which I've already discussed with PLDs. The SOP is a sum of products. Any gate can be expressed as an SOP. Any combinational truth table can be expressed as an SOP, sum of products. And what that is SOP. It's ANDs all going into an OR. The OR is the sum of a bunch of products. If these ANDs all go into an OR, all I got to do is just figure out what's on the inputs to the ANDs and think about how the exclusive OR is set up. It's high when it's different. When is it different? When B is a 0 and A is a 1. There's a 1 there. How do I make the output of that AND gate a 1? It doesn't matter what this one's doing because I've got an OR gate right here. If the output of that AND gate is 1, the output of this OR gate is definitely 1, because the output of an OR gate is any input is a 1, the output is a 1. So just make this AND gate with the inputs of B and A. So how are we going to do this? Well, A is already a 1. B is a 0. Why not invert B? The output of this first AND gate will be 1. It doesn't matter what's in the second AND gate. The output for the whole circuit will be 1. Okay, now let's look at from the next time there's a 1 in this particular truth table. It's right here. When does that occur? When B is a 1 and A is a 0. It's the opposite case of the first one. So let's just use this second AND gate to produce a 1 in that particular occurrence. B is a 1. I don't have to do anything with it. A is a 0. Why not invert it? And the output of that AND gate is a 1. What's the output of the OR gate? Well, it's one of the inputs is a 1. So the output is a 1. Test this thing with other combinations. What happens when B is a 0 and A is a 0? So B is a 0. That's a 1 right there. A is a 0. What is the output of this AND gate? It's ANDing a 1 and a 0. It's a 0. Again, B is a 0. A is a 0. We're inverting A. That's a 1. B 0 ANDed with not A 1. What's the output of this AND gate? 0. Oh my gosh, the output's a 0. We're talking right there right now. Okay, just like we'd expected. We already talked about the first two cases. Go ahead, try it for A is a 1. B is a 1. 1, 1, 1, 1. Do our respective inversions, 0, 0. Basically, anytime those AND gates are getting a 0, the output of that AND gate is a 0, output of that AND gate is a 0, the output of the OR gate is a 0. We're right there, 0. So pretty cool, huh? What we're doing is we're taking individual product terms for every single line in that truth table. And if there's a 1 there, we're putting an AND gate that makes it true. It puts the outputs a 1. So let's go ahead and see if you can do the same thing with the exclusive NOR. So again, what is the truth table of the exclusive NOR? BA, XNOR, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. It's high when it's the same. 1, 0, 0, 1. Let's go ahead and see if you can do that. Okay, so first off, there's two terms that are 1. That one and that one. It's an SOP. It's ORing both of those product terms. What's the first product term? Well, B is a 0, A is a 0. How do I make this AND gate become a 1 when B is a 0 and A is a 0? Why not invert it, both of those guys? What is the second ones? Well, B is a 1, A is a 1. Don't have to do anything with them. Does this thing work when I try to feed it this value or this value? It does work. It's going to put an output as 0 for both those cases. Okay, what I'm trying to show you here is exclusive OR and exclusive NOR are composed of AND gates, OR gates, and NOT gates. And I'm trying to show you guys that the SOP expression, it's pretty cool, it's pretty useful. You're just taking a truth table and you're making the product terms that are 1. You're putting an AND gate so it makes them 1, and they're all feeding a single OR gate. The SOP is a pretty handy way of displaying logical functions, and additionally, it's what's used in those PLDs. You're either going to connect it or disconnect in that particular row for an AND gate, and then it's all going to be fed into those ORs. Additionally, this is what we're going to be doing for some Carnot maps a little bit later on. Finally, I just want to bring this lecture to a close. We discussed two gates, the exclusive OR and the exclusive NOR. We discussed the truth table. We discussed kind of their description about them. We discussed the timing diagrams, discussed the selective inversion feature, we discussed how to use them as an adder. We discussed error checking and comparison. We discussed the SOP. Last but not least, there are multiple input exclusive ORs and exclusive NORs. And the best way to describe how these things function, you may never run across these things. An exclusive OR, the output is high if input is odd. When I say odd, I'm not saying weird. What I'm saying is it's an odd number of ones. The exclusive NORs, output is high if input is even. They're an even number of ones. The reason why you do something like this is what's called parity, which we'll go into later. Parity is a means of error checking for sending out a stream of data. You want to go ahead, did I send what I mean to send? And what you can do is do odd parity or even parity. You might be able to use an exclusive OR or an exclusive NOR with multiple inputs to go ahead and do that check for you. Okay, this kind of concludes the last of our bonus round of gates. We went over the NAND, the NOR, the exclusive OR, and the exclusive NOR.